I'm going to show you how to read the pattern for this diamond friendship bracelet. It uses 12 strings folded over at the top and separated out according to the color pattern that they show you on the actual pattern. So it's a white, it's a pink, it's a green and a red, and a green and a black, and it's the same from the other side. The first thing you want to notice about working with patterns is you're always working with the same two strings at a time, the first two strings. This pattern shows me here this pink arrow in the down position. That's telling me it's a backward knot. So I'm going to make a backward knot. Two backward knots on the white string. And you're going to put them back into the slots. The next stitch, it tells you, is the same thing. You're going to pick up the next two strings and you're doing a backward knot, a red onto the green string. Pink. That's one. That's two. And the next two strings is the green and the black we're working with. So we take them out, and it's showing you an arrow down to the left. That's a backward knot with the black onto the green. So the circle of color is actually what the knot should look like when it's completed. So we got a black knot. And now we're going across. We're going to pick up the next two strings, which is the other green and black. And now the arrow is pointing down to the right. So that's telling me that's a forward knot. So I'm going to make my forward knot. Then we pick up the next two strings, the red and the green. And you look at the pattern and it tells you a red arrow down to the right, which means a forward knot. A red knot onto the green. That's one. That's two. And we tuck them in. And then the last two knots, it's the pink. Last two strings, the pink and the white. We're going to go right here. It shows you down to the right. So that's a forward knot. That arrow down means forward. And then you tuck them back in. And what I like to do as I go along, because now I completed that first row of knots, I like to put just a little mark. You can see I did that over here when I was doing my pattern to make that bracelet, so I can keep track of that I did that complete row. So now I'm looking at the second row. Now this second row has this pink string just sticking out to the left like that, which means you don't do anything with that string. You skip that string and you move on to the next two. So we're taking out the white and the red. And that red arrow down to the left is telling me I take the red one and I do a backward knot on top of the white. So that's two backward knots on top of the white. And you tuck them back in again. You take out the next two. We have green and black and we're doing a backward knot, the black onto the green. Now we have the two greens, and again the arrow's down to the left, so that's a backward knot on top of each other. Oops. And again, the backward knot is the letter D, and you tuck them in. Now we have the black, now the arrow's pointing down to the right, so that's telling me it's a forward knot. So that's the key to making reading patterns, is understanding the arrows and what it actually means. So the arrow down to the right is a forward knot. Now the next two is the red and the white. And we're doing a forward knot down, red onto the white, a forward knot. One. That's two. And then we'll tuck these back in. And because the pink is sticking out again on the right side like this, that means you skip that string and you move on. You don't touch those two strings on that second row. Actually, if you'll notice, every row every other row we'll be eliminating the outermost string. So the next we can mark off that we did it. I do it over here again. That's the second row. You completed that second row across, so you mark that you did it, just to keep track of where you are. So now we know we're on the third row of knots. And here, you'll see we're gonna pick up the pink and the red and do a knot down to the left, which is a backward knot of the red onto the pink. And now the red stays on the outside. The next one is black and the white. It's a backward knot. The arrow's down to the left. So we do the letter D, make a black knot on the white. Okay, now you're just going to continue following the pattern in the same way we're doing it, following the arrows. Forward knot, forward knot, forward knot. And then the red on the outside means you leave the red out. You don't include that in that row of stitches. As you go into the pattern, you will see in certain spots, right here and right here, that the arrows begin to change. This pink, it has an arrow down and an arrow this way. So what this is telling me is that when I get to this 12th row, I have to do a backward knot and then a forward knot with the same string. So that's what that arrow means, backward knot, forward knot. And that would account for the two knots on that green string. The same thing here with the red. In the next location, it would be a backward knot and a forward knot onto that green string. So that's what those arrows mean. Here, the two blacks together is just one backward knot down in that direction, the black on the black. So it's all about reading these little circles and the different knots when you make a friendship bracelet from a pattern. And this is how you read a pattern in order to make a friendship bracelet.